What do experiments with lasers, X-rays, and spark gap transmitters have in common? Besides being fun, dangerous, and partially illegal in some countries, they all rely on a dependable high-voltage power supply. Unfortunately, commercial laboratory high-voltage power supplies are quite expensive, and completely homebrew solutions don't usually score very high in the dependable category. But luckily, there's a way of combining commercial reliability and cost-saving homebrewing. The foundation for this project is a commercial adjustable laser power supply. The supply is powered directly from mains voltage and has the capability of outputting an adjustable output voltage of up to 30 kV. The maximum available output current of 20 to 25 milliamps is plenty for interesting high voltage experiments. The laser supply was mounted inside a 19-inch rack mount case, which provides a large enough front panel to house all the controls and meters. The front panel features a fancy protected single-pole single-throw switch to enable the high voltage output, a small momentary switch for bursts of high voltage, a 10-turn potentiometer to adjust the output voltage, a current meter for up to 30 milliamps, a ground connector, a voltmeter for up to 50 kilovolts, and last but not least, a rubber grommet that's being used as feed-through for a high-voltage cable rated for up to 50 kilovolts. A very inexpensive high-voltage connector was used to terminate the output cable. The internal wiring is extremely straightforward. That is, once I figured out the correct pinout of the power supply itself. The leftmost connector is the input for the mains voltage, the center one primarily is used for the voltage adjustment, and the rightmost is for the enable connection. In order to save you from wasting time and having to endure accidental misfires, I listed the exact pinout here. This pinout table, as well as high resolution images of all connections made, can also be found on my text blog. The link can be found in the video description. The AC mains voltage input is connected through a fused and switchable IEC 320 connector. Well, I guess technically it's an IEC 60320 connector now, a C14 type connector to be precise. Next, let's talk about the current and the voltmeter. Installing the current meter didn't really pose much of a challenge. It was simply connected between ground and the ground return path of the load. Since it is pretty much unavoidable for the voltmeter to be in contact with the up to 30,000 volts of output voltage, a 1 gigaohm resistor and a 50 microamp ammeter was pulled out of my bag of tricks. The 1 gigaohm resistor was connected directly to the high voltage output, and the other side of the resistor was connected to the positive terminal of a 50 microamp ammeter. The negative terminal of the ammeter was connected to ground. Following Ohm's law, the current through a 1 gigaohm resistor is 1 microamp per kilovolt, which conveniently corresponds to a current of 30 microamps at 30 kilovolts. This conveniently turns a microamp meter in a kilovolt meter. Of course, the real current is a little bit lower due to the meter's internal resistance of about 2 kiloohms. However, the resulting error is insignificant. Even with an additional 125 kiloohms in series with the test setup, the measured voltage would still be accurate to within 2 decimal places. The resistor was soldered directly to the high voltage cable and then covered in a few layers of insulating varnish. To further insulate and protect the solder junction, a few pieces of textile drenched in epoxy glue were carefully wrapped around the solder joint. After everything was put in place and the epoxy was dried, it was finally time to test the power supply. The power supply immediately did what it's supposed to do, and the kilovolt meter seems to work just fine. Never has the sound of corona discharge sounded so rewarding. With the dry firing out of the way and no magic smoke escaping, it was time to move on to an actual project. This crude spark gap transmitter with a frequency of about 3 MHz was the perfect candidate for initial tests with this high voltage power supply. It was very fun to control the firing rate of the spark gap with the applied voltage. But the spark gap transmitter technology is going to be the subject of another video. For now, thanks for watching, please like, comment and subscribe, and see you next time.